have today are comes from his inventions. Tesla. Teller was one too, by the way, but I get them mixed up every now and then. Tesla. And George Bush's real dad was Tesla's associate or his assistant. And George Bush played around in the labs of Tesla when he was a boy. You heard me mention Prescott Bush, and Prescott Bush was George Bush's granddad, who helped fuel Hitler. And so what he did is he adopted Sheriff, the boy, who then became George H.W. Bush, who grew up to be President George H.W. Bush, 41. And then there was another man called Bill Clinton. You can find all this stuff up on the computer if you know how. And Bill Clinton lived in Arkansas with his mom. And there was a guy that was governor of Arkansas called Rockefeller. Winthorpe Rockefeller. And Clinton became his illegitimate son. You can type Bill Clinton, Rockefeller, just those two last names, it'll pop up in the search organs. I've done it many times. And it says William Rockefeller Clinton. It'll come up and tell you about it. And so that was President number 42. And see, I came out of politics, and I remember the argument of the conservatives saying we've looked everywhere and we cannot find a birth certificate for Bill Clinton. We can't find one. I remember that argument way back then. So Bill Clinton doesn't have a birth certificate. George H.W. Bush didn't have a birth certificate. And now this character doesn't have a birth certificate. Okay? And so nobody can find out who this man is. And it was rumored, you know, about all of that Dunham woman and the guy from Kenya. That's not who his parents are. And then it was rumored that Malcolm X was his dad. And when you look at pictures of Malcolm X and this guy, they look like twins. But see, what you don't understand is they could take a cell from Malcolm X and grow him. Remember Jurassic Park? Remember that? And so, you leaving?
My car.
Okay.
The light was on and I ran out of gas. So I got to get to the gas station.
You need somebody to follow you?
I think I'll be okay. I can get to this BP, but I've got to go check the oil.
Okay.
The light's on.
And so,
it's
that.
Yeah.
He's making a tape. And so there you got three presidents without birth certificates, the last three, okay? And so the Barack Obama thing, I just threw that out on a talk show, and I said, you know, he could either be a breeder baby or he could be a clone. And I was just being radical when I did that, which I try to be sometimes. And so what happened was I'm reading this article, and it said, is Obama a Golan? G-O-L-E-M, Golan. And I had remembered seeing stuff on the Golan before, so I started doing research. And what a Golan is magically created life form from an inanimate object. That means that they take something and make it alive. You understand? Well, yeah, it's a Hebrew word, but I'm trying to explain to them that they take it, they take something that's not alive, and they make it alive. So they could build a body, a shell of a body, and a magical Jew could bring life into that according to their mythology. And so the newsletter that I wrote and the research that I did actually tied it into the Antichrist for me. It was just unbelievable stuff. So I sent it out. I said, I know people are going to think I'm crazy, but I went ahead and sent it out. But in other words, he could be a clone with the magical powers of the Golem, which would be a supernatural force. Now, you got to keep that in mind, that just because they say they can bring life to an inanimate body, that's not talking about life like we've got. That's talking about a demon going into an inanimate body and becoming alive like a puppet. See what I'm saying? And so in the Encyclopedia Britannica, it even tells you how to activate the Golem and to how the rabbis activated them and deactivated them. And so then I came across an article that said that right next to his office is a man, and this man has no job description, but he's placed there to reprogram him. If his program begins to run out, it said that this particular man has an office next to him to reprogram him. Now, he doesn't have to be a clone for all of this. He could at the same time be a human being that has grown up under mind control, which his history shows, even if he were Dunham's kid, she came up as an American communist in the American Communist Party, and he would have come up under mind control anyway. And every mind control person that has a handler, and so this would be his handler that programs his mind like a tape recorder for him to do what Kissinger, Rothschild, and Rockefeller and these folks want him to do. Any way that it's going to hit the ground, we're in trouble. Because the President of the United States, the only power that he has actually left in our country is to sign things. And when he signs things, it brings it to law of our land. It does, and now they've got the executive orders, which makes laws. So they have, within little over 50 days, they have brought America under Barack Obama totally into a socialist country. Socialist means Nazi, by the way. Fourth rank. And he just came into office, sat down, and started signing the stuff. He's not thinking all of this stuff up, I'm telling you that. He cannot make a speech without a teleprompter. And they're thinking about fixing the podium. Have you seen these computers that lie flat? That don't, they've got them, and you can talk from, they're going to make his pulpit like that so he can stand there and read instead of looking at the prompters. But, Yeah, he knows how to present a good speech. See, he claims, now nobody knows because we can't see his records. They won't show us his Occidental College records. They won't show us his his records from his high school over in Hawaii. They have no records of him being born in Hawaii in any of the hospitals. They won't show us his Hawaii supposedly birth certificate. They won't show us his birth certificate that's supposed to be over in Kenya. They won't show us his records in Columbia University. They won't show us his records in Harvard. They claim that he was the first Harvard law degree black professor on that newspaper. There's no articles up there by him. There's no pictures of him on basketball teams, though they claim he was a basketball player. There's no pictures of him dating women, going to proms, and doing things like people do, you know. Hope they never find any of my pictures. But, you know, being honest about it, we leave tracks, and with the computers now, you can't hide things the way you used to. And so the articles, and I did a lot of research on him, the articles and all the stuff that I did on Obama ends up saying, we do not know who this man is. Now, I've read articles where he's 80% Arabs, where he's half white and half black, where he's not any kin to this woman, Dunham, where she, Dunham, is still alive and her Social Security number is operating, where there was a lot of money laundering going on in that family for all of these many years, where they were raised in pure communism, all kinds of stuff that I've done research on. I'll bring you that check, okay? Okay. Okay. I'm going to quit anyway. But the point that I'm getting at is it says nobody knows who he is. That's where it all ends up. Nobody knows who he is. I know you got a long ride. My people, are y'all staying in a motel? You got a long ride? Yeah, they're from Lakeland. Yeah, we have people coming from here and there and around. God bless you. You feel better? Yeah. And so that's about what I got into was the breeder as opposed to the... See, what you would say is Bill Clinton is a breeder. George Bush is an adoptee into an Illuminati family. This guy could be a clone. And I came across research from one guy that does a lot of research on the Rockefeller family, and he turned up the Nazis. They had the ability to do cloning as far back as 1927. And he gives a testimony that Mengele, have you ever heard that name? He was an SS doctor, and he used to take heads of people in Germany and keep them alive, and half human and half animal and stuff like that. He was a monster. And when he came to America, a lot of your mind control people say that they were mind control trained under him. But he gives a testimony of Mengele going down into Brazil. And Mengele came in as a veterinarian and took care of horses and cows. But meantime, he would go around the little village to the women, and he said he would mix some kind of concoction. And he said they renamed the city down in Brazil because, like in a normal city, there'd be something like one twin in, say, every 20. And down in that little city, there would be something like six twins in every 10, something like that. and said that he would he not only implanted those twins into those women down in Brazil, they renamed the city Twin City because there were so many twins born in that city. And guess what? They were born from dark-skinned ladies with blue eyes and blonde hair and fair skin. And so they had the ability to do all of these things. And now, just last week, I heard on TV that you can order your designer baby. If you want blue eyes, you can order it, blonde hair. So now they're using that same technology down in the world today. I guess we're finished because Brother Mark's saying I got to go. And he Well, you see, when we start out with 20 or 30 people and it keeps getting smaller. When we start casting out devils, it people, you know, they'll come and then all of a sudden they stop.
Why do you think they stop?
I think the devil stops.
I know before you started, man, I was just going crazy because I haven't eaten all day. I was trying to fast today. And I was crazy. They say something happened, blood sugar got low, and I went and ate some chocolate in my car. I had to.
Yeah, but you felt better. You did good. Yeah, because they know they're going. See what they do.
Play on that. They say if you fast, you better be ready because it makes you, I mean, God's power comes up and the devil will attack.
Well, they're trying to stop. What they wanted you to do is to say, I just don't feel like sitting through this and I'll come back next week. That's what they want you to do.
I want you to leave. Thankfully, I had some M&M's in the car.
Yeah. We're going to call you the bold man.